Welcome to Comic Chop News. I'm Dan, and today we're going to be reviewing in a non-spoiler review of Battle Angel Alita, or Alita Battle Angel, as it's now termed in the movie. I read the manga and watched the anime back in the past, so it's always going to be Battle Angel Alita for me a bit. So let's get started with the movie. It is directed by Robert Rodriguez and produced by Jim Cameron. It's kind of hard to say how much Jim Cameron's involvement is, but this movie is stunningly beautiful. The visuals, the world building. If Jim Cameron didn't have a real hands-on approach with this movie, then kudos to Robert Rodriguez, because I watched this in IMAX 3D. The city, the world, it was ugly yet beautiful at the same time, if that's understandable. The sound design, especially, maybe it's just for the IMAX, but when the rain was dropping, you can hear it dropping kind of different quadrants of the theater. The 3D of it was not overwhelming like you see in some where things are popping out. This is more like Avatar, where it felt like the colors were more jumping out at you instead of actual like a sword or some crap like that flying at you. I have to give credit to the main actress in here, Rosa Salazar. I will say I was a little worried going into it because the CG with the eyes and everything was a little distracting. Once you get past the first 5 minutes of the so-called uncanny valley of watching the CGI mesh of her face, the overlay of the eyes, you start to forget about it. And I don't want to really compare the two because they're two different products, but compared to the Ghost in the Shell Scarlett Johansson movie, Salazar brought so much character, emotion. There was something in the character that you kind of started to enjoy and like, where Scarlett Johansson in Ghost in the Shell was just hollow and robotic. I guess it kind of fit the movie, sort of, but just nothing to latch on there. This actually has a very good cast of characters around Rosa Salazar. Mahershala Ali is Vector. You have Jennifer Connelly, who I think is a witch. She just ages gracefully and stays beautiful. She plays Shireen. She is Christoph Waltz's ex-wife, Shireen, and he plays Dr. Ido. I'm not going to go too much into story specifics because I don't feel I should, because you want to be immersed in the world. So I know early reviews have been kind of mixed. This was a manga and anime. So going in, just know you're not going in for Shakespeare or great writing. They're meant to be just pop culture, and you just try to immerse yourself in the world and enjoy it for what it is. This has action sequences that are fantastic to watch. Again, the CG at some points can be a little dizzying. There is what I consider almost like a death race roller derby type thing called Motorball. That I'd say it's about 15 minutes of the movie where there's some fantastic sequences with this sport that is in this world. And you just have to lose yourself in the moment. It's fascinating because this is a project that when they first announced it, I thought could never happen because it just, the technology wasn't there and you really needed somebody like Jim Cameron to be involved in it to see it through and actually say, you know, kind of F you, I can make this happen. And I'll be damned if he didn't. Rosa Salazar, again, like, I can't say enough about her performance because she really had to sell it. I don't know if it's mocap that they use for, I imagine it was, or some kind of suit so they can make it look robotic. Some of the interactions, like there is a love interest named Hugo in there, which in the movie there will be some complications of the relationship. He wasn't a wonderful actor. I'm still a young guy, so there's room to grow. But the romance got a little bit Anakin Skywalker, Padme Amidala from the prequels. And again, you can only do what's on the page. And it was a big part of the movie, but it wasn't a game breaker where you're just like, oh, screw this, I'm done, I can't do this anymore. It never got to that point where you're just groaning. The end had a couple of scenes that could have been probably sold a little bit better. Again, it's breakneck action. It's what you want. The score, it was good, but it wasn't anything that you walk out of the theater going, man, I don't know how that movie could have survived without that score. It doesn't make you want to run out and buy it. See this movie without, stay away from the reviews, because Rotten Tomatoes, of course, you know, you read it's horrible, this movie's a wreck, and I can see why people would. I thought a real weak point of the movie was Ed Skrein, because he was playing kind of just the typical Ed Skrein character. His character Zapan's just kind of a cocky dick, and kind of Ed Skrein's bag at this point from when he acts. Maybe I just haven't seen a movie where I've seen him be kind of serious and act his ass off, because my experience is Deadpool, Game of Thrones, and there was one other thing I watched that I don't remember in this movie. So I could be wrong on this. Robert Rodriguez, I really... When the Blu-ray comes out, or 4K, I want to see the extras on this, because I want to see how much his involvement was with it and just how they made this movie come alive. I'm going to give it a 3.5, because again, there are story faults with it, but I love the fact that this got made. And it might make more money than I think people really... are guessing, because I do think there's gonna be a surge of word of mouth a little bit of, hey, this movie's kind of crazy and I can't believe someone made this. Again, like my 3.5, what goes into it also, the main villain reveal was a little weak. Jackie Earl Haley is CGI'd all to hell as one of the main big bads. But again, nothing that breaks the movie to the point where I'd say don't go see it. So with that being said, watch it and enjoy it. I just think that you gotta give it at least a chance. The way to see it for me would be to go see an IMAX 3D. Much like Avatar, I think it helps the experience. I can't say whether this is something that I need to rewatch right away, because I came out kind of amped by it, which I don't really get that often, where I walk out and I'm like, holy hell, that was kind of fantastic. But I went in with low expectations, partially because of the little mixed reactions you saw here and there from early screenings. The movie, also, they leave open for a sequel. It definitely, they left a door wide open. And I'd kind of like to see it. It might take years. I mean, it took years for them to make this movie. And for those who now are trained by Marvel to wait for the credit scenes at the end, or see if there's after credit scenes, there is no mid-credit scene, there is no end credit scene. So I did the work for you. I stayed and waited just in case. So with that being said, thank you for watching, and I hope I influenced some of you to at least give this movie a chance, because I think it deserves it, and I like that chances are being taken still and bringing a property that I didn't think could be made onto the big screen. And the fact that we have visionaries like Jim Cameron who kind of put their ass out there to try and get movies like this made. And more credit to him. And I'm kind of curious to see Avatar 2 now, because they kind of made me go, wow, if he did this, what's Avatar 2 going to be like? So, good night. Thank you for watching. Like, subscribe, comment, and take care.